Now let's talk about variables. A lot of times we need to deal with the data and information within our application. Variables are like containers for those data and information. We store them in the variable and then we use the variable. The very first thing we need to know about variables in PHP is their structures. All the variables start with a dollar sign. Then we write the name of the variable, for example, example. Then we write equal sign to assign a new value, and then we write the value itself, here for example 10. Then in the end, like all of the statements in PHP, we need to add semicolon or we would get a syntax error. That's it. Now if I write echo example and go to my terminal and run PHP, because the name of my file is index.php, here it has printed out 10, which was the value we assigned to my variable. Perfect. Now the next thing we need to talk about is the name of a variable. The name of a variable can contain alphabets, numbers, and underscore. For example, a name like example underline 2 is completely valid. We can even have numbers in it, no problem. We don't get any error, as you can see here. But the most important part of a name in PHP is the first letter that we need to be very careful about. The very first letter cannot be a number. So a variable like name equals to 1, or name with uppercase, or name with underscore name is completely valid, no problem. But if my first letter is a number like 3 example, as you can see, even my IDE shows me that this is not correct. This is not a correct format of a variable. And even if I run my file, I'll get a syntax error, unexpected 3, because it didn't expect 3, a number, as a first letter. So we should be very careful about that. Another thing we should note is that the case of a variable, the case is very important. For example, if I have a variable called example equals to 10, and even if one letter is different, is in E in this case is uppercase, it's completely different. These two variables are completely different. They are not the same. So we should be very careful about that. And the last thing we should know about variable is that since PHP is taking care of the types for us, you can assign values with different types and you won't get an error. If you have worked with languages like C or Java, you might have seen some syntax like int x equals to like 10. In PHP, we do not need to write this part. PHP will take care of that for us, and I can have another variable, which is a string, for example, and no problem. Both of them are perfectly fine and valid. And when we want to change the value of a variable, we simply assign the new value to it. And even if the type of the new value is different, PHP will take care of it for us. For example, if I have x equal 10, and if I changed it to x equals AMIR, it's completely valid. The one with x equals 10 is a number, the one with x equals AMIR is a string, but PHP will take care of that for us, no problem. If I echo x, I will get no error, and here I get AMIR because it has updated the value from 10 to AMIR. We'll talk about data types in PHP a little bit later, but for now, for this topic, this is the end. This is the end of the variables, and let's go to the next topic.